Moving further, we have with us Mr. Bobby Paul, General Manager Marketing Online, and Ms. Neeta Nair, Assistant Editor Impact Exchange for Media, for the Fireside Chat on monetizing news and winning the localization challenge for brands. So I welcome both of you on screen. A very warm welcome, and over to you, Neeta.
Thank you so much, Kyati. See, Malayalam Manorama is known for a lot of things. The most widely read newspaper in India, the fifth most read daily in the country as per IRS 2019. I would like to describe it as a Mammootty and Mohanlal combined of Malayalam news. That is exactly how big a star Malayalam Manorama is in the market. And I hope my guest agrees.
Yes, I agree to you, 10%. And I love that anecdote you used.
So for a fireside chat here today, we have with us someone from the online arm of the group, which has been doing remarkably well in the digital news space. So let me welcome Mr. Bobby Paul, GM Marketing, Malayalam Manorama Online. Hello, Mr. Paul.
Thank you, Neeta, for such a warm welcome. Looking forward.
Tell me, Kerala loves its newspaper. You know, loud tea stall, conversations and news is very, very common in every nook and corner of the state. Now, how easy or difficult was it over the years to get the average Malayali to switch to digital news?
Quite a pertinent question. This is not something which is not just a matter of fact, a concern for Manorama alone, but for the entire publishing community or publishers it is. Because when you grow a product and you have parallel products coming in, definitely the chance for cannibalization is always there. But having said that, you cannot still work with your typewriter, right? So the technology has changed, the ease of working, the patterns have changed. So you have to keep up with the times. So it is basically something similar for publishing world also. We have to embrace what is coming new. And especially for a young nation like India and a very literate state like Kerala, where digital adoption is very high, mobile penetration is almost 100%. And you talk about the news consumption habits traditionally, and we are news junkies. So definitely, as your time spent is going towards mobile, definitely you have to be there. So you cannot miss out on that. Even though we have a very, very strong print presence across the broadcast and radio, we kind of cover almost like 90-91% of the Kerala or Malayali diaspora.
Okay. But is it largely the youth which is, kind of accessing the website if you have to compare?
Not really. So last couple of years has been, already a change happening, digital adoption, the drop in mobile and data prices in India is already one of the lowest. You're talking about comparing it to US. It is around $12 in US for 1 GB of data, and in India it is almost like 20-30 cents. So there's a huge difference. So anybody can be mobile can access news. And Malayalis as a community has been quite spread out within India and also outside India. So you have traffic coming up from more than 200 geographies. Now there are a lot of avenues for you to get national and international news. But what about hyperlocal, which we master it over 130-year-old audios? So that is what our strength comes in.
So the user base has been shot up massively, even because of the pandemic, which kind of left with a lot of people.
Yeah, so if you take a slice and dice the demographic of users or audience, our predominant group is 18 to 44 years, like most of the publishers. But definitely you have users coming in from all age segments, especially after this pandemic where people cannot move out. And Kerala was lucky even in the last first wave of COVID that the distribution of newspaper never got affected. So so it was it is spread out, but the concentration is between 18 to 44 years.
Now I'd like to come outside of Kerala and give a personal example. So my father is used to read two, who's based out of Bombay, used to read two newspapers, English newspapers a day. But even in the remote chances, I tell him to delete his Malayala Manorama app from his phone because of space constraints. There is likely to be a war in the house. So you have a very, very loyal user there. So tell me, have you ever seen merit in, you know, monetizing this, you know, maybe through a subscription model? Not so much for the e-paper, but, you know, the constant updates, I think, is what they prefer. So have you seen about, looked at a subscription there?
So I will answer your question in two parts. So first, a small trick of the trade for your dad. So Manorama app, you can just toggle back from English and Malayalam in just one touch of a button, right? So that's a solution for that. And coming to the second part of the question, definitely, our e-paper is already behind a paywall for the last 2 years. Mm-hmm. We are having solid plans to launch our subscription services by end of this financial year, at least. So we have a quite a good tangent of audience, which actually not present in Kerala, who want to know what is happening back in Kerala, would be the nearshore customers for this, kind of service, subscription services. But monetizing generic news in India is a big challenge. A lot of players are trying to tackle and try to find a solution, and try to evolve. So we will also be getting soon on that track, and hopefully things work out.
Okay. Yeah, another thing is, Kerala politics is always trending on social media, be it left versus BJP or Shailaja teacher. No youth living outside of Kerala who can't read or write Malayalam like me, but they are seen actively discussing state politics. So how are you ensuring that you have their attention, and how strong is your social media game?
Well, so again, I'll answer in two parts. So first part is basically, we are talking about a brand which is kind of a legacy brand, who has been around for a long time. 134 plus years. So it is something which people are used to reading in your houses, discussing at homes and offices, and even small chai kadas and chai corners, what we call. So it's very ingrained in the system. And since the literacy rates and intellectual awareness levels are very high in Kerala, definitely news is something which they crave for. And of course, politics is a big part of that. Even though I'm not an official commentator on that, but I'll say that whatever content you can hook your customers or audience with, that is what you're going to pitch for, right? So that's exactly what we are doing, and finding decent amount of success over the years. And digital also, nothing not quite new for us, is almost 22, 23 years we have been in digital. So slow and rocky start, but yes. Yeah.
You actually mentioned legacy news publishers. And I want to come to this aspect. There are many relatively new digital news portals like the News Minute who are capturing the imagination of the youth. Now tell me, in this traditional publisher versus new age portals debate, what are the things that you are doing to emerge at the top?
See, India has quite a lot of headroom in the news space. Specifically talking about digital news space. Why? Because our country is so heterogeneous. So it has 22 official languages, more than 1,000 languages and dialects. So you cannot cater to all the audience at one go, right? The news what a millennial or a Gen Z user will crave for is not what a 40 plus year old person will be looking at. So there is enough and more space for a lot of players to come and operate. It will only help rejuvenate the ecosystem. So what is good about this new, I'm not naming any platforms or sites, but they are young, they are very nimble, they are very adept to technologies. You don't have a baggage, what you have from a lot of legacy operations. So these are all the merits. But when it comes to merits or pros for legacy publishers, is our trust what people have in us, the kind of network of news gathering, factual news gathering, which has our whole set of reporters spread throughout Kerala and India and outside, and a lot of stringers who work with us who actually gather a lot of credible news. And there's a mechanism where we kind of treat it and make sure that know, what we put out is kind of genuine in most of the time.
Now, I'd like to now come to revenue. You know, for years, online publishers have accused tech companies like Google of getting an undue advantage from their news content. And now they've launched something called the News Showcase, which kind of provides monthly payouts to partner publishers. Now, as the biggest news brand in Kerala, do you see merit in being a partner with Google?
Well, I cannot really comment on that, but what little knowledge I have about it is basically, it is a curated content offering from Google for various publishers. And regionally is yet to be launched. So I think mainstream English and Hindi is what I think it's already launched. So we are in discussion. So the discussion, what we are having is about, you know, monetizing the content or you know, curated content and, you know, some amount of monetization which Google gives us. Now on the monetization part is still a little far off because we have not even started the relationship already. So once that is in place, then we'll think about the monetization part. But right now it is only content and monetizing content. So ads will follow a little later maybe.
And, you know, off late, we've seen this huge explosion of regional language content and news. The people beyond the metros and the big cities have never been this important. So tell me, in the past couple of months or maybe a year, are you seeing more and more national advertisers coming on Malayalam Manorama and as opposed to maybe 2-3 years ago, as opposed to also, you know, having national brands coming out from Kerala like V-Guard or Muthoot advertising on the platform?
Yeah, so we have a healthy mix of national and regional or retail brands which operate from Kerala. So when I say healthy mix, if I give a percentage terms, it's almost like a 50-50. So basically, all the national brands which want to tap into the consumer state like Kerala, where Kerala economy is kind of insulated to a lot of what is happening within India. Because there is a lot of money flowing from outside of India, especially GCC and elsewhere. So what happens is that there is a buoyant consumer spends already happening from Kerala. And if you look at auto, white goods kind of numbers from their respective organization data, you can always see auto, Kerala, Maharashtra will be always on the top. So there is quite a lot of demand for that. So national and within Kerala, spenders are always there. So the mix and match may change. For example, the second wave, which just happened in Kerala and elsewhere in India, there was a bit of slowdown for retail market because things were locked out and retails were not operating and things like that. So it was a major prominence for the national brands. But having said that, once the lockdown eased up from 17th onwards and shops and establishments started opening up, things are coming back, but it will take a little more time.
But tell me, are these ads on Malayalam Manorama customized for a Malayali audience? I'll tell you why I asked, because I was going through one of the sessions earlier on our own platform. Kavita Ganeshan from TVS Eurogrip said that, you know, there was this TVC that they wanted to play in the Kerala market, and which had a cat crossing your path, which kind of shows bad luck. But in Kerala, we don't have that particular superstitions. We have many more, but we don't have that particular superstition. So they completely changed that to something else. So are you seeing that happen even on digital, on Malayalam Manorama Digital, wherein, you know, ads are being made specifically for your kind of audience?
Yes, there is quite a good amount of effort what is happening on localization front, catering specifically to Malayali diaspora in Malayalam language. But there is quite a bit of challenge for a lot of agencies and international brands when they kind of, localize for the local taste. So we also help a lot of brands with our content team to actually localize. Now, it is not just literal translation. It is more of getting that feeling or vibe of what Malayali diaspora treat as good and not so good. I'll tell you a little example. I mean, there was a large campaign from a very leading video sharing site last Onam, where they showed their crushing papadam as a contest. So there was a bit of a backlash which happened, telling that it's food basically, so you cannot mistreat food, right? So if you would have, if the brand would have understood what Malayalam or Malayalis are and what they value, then this kind of small mistakes would have been avoided. So that is the place where Malayalam Manorama or Manorama Online can help a lot of brands to, you know, localize content. Finally, it is said that it is not what you say, but what they hear that matters.
True. So Onam is going to come up in the next few months. What are the big innovative ways in which you are luring the advertisers to Malayalam Manorama Online?
Yeah, it's Onam is almost around the corner. It's another 1.5 months, if you put numbers to it. This year, our overarching theme for Onam is basically cautious optimism, I would call it. Enjoy responsibility, celebrate responsibility. The approach we are taking for this Onam is basically on vertical-based or segment-based approach, because the needs and requirements of each of the verticals like auto, FMCG, fashion, gifting, all this is different. Now being, a lot of people opting for digital or omni-channel kind of route, we are customizing a lot of options for this kind of large segments, which I think they can cut across the clutter which normally happens in Onam. So this is where our focus is going to be for this Onam.
And how much of a growth in revenue are you expecting, foreseeing in this season?
See, every year you clock a new revenue benchmark during the Onam season. But if you compare it from last year to this year, we should be looking at least 20-25% growth over last year. And last year has also been a growth in spite of being a pandemic. I'm talking about digital per se.
Okay. Fantastic. And with that, we've come to the end of this discussion. Thank you so much, Mr. Paul, for joining us. May you have a fantastic Onam season, and may Mahabali bring with him with a lot of hope and joy for Malayalam Manorama and whole of Kerala and the country, to be honest. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. And it was good speaking to you and having all the listeners across India or worldwide. Hope things work out and all stay safe and have a nice Onam.
Thank you so much. Right. Thank you so much for those kind. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you, Mr. Paul. And thank you, Neeta, for steering this wonderful conversation, bringing in such nuggets of insights through this conversation. Thank you so much.